السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. يا رب لك الحمد أنت نور السماوات والأرض وما فيهن، ولك الحمد أنت قيوم السماوات والأرض وما فيهن، ولك الحمد أنت ملك السماوات والأرض وما فيهن، أنت الحق ووعدك حق ولقاؤك حق والجنة حق والنار حق. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا رسول الله، نشهدك يا ربنا أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة، فكشف الله تعالى به عن هذه الأمة الغمة، وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فاللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على هذا النبي الأمي الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته واقتفى أثره وسار على دربه إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة في دين الله بدعة. أما بعد، فيقول الله تعالى في كتابه العزيز: إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. مرحبا بكم يا إسلام. جمعة مباركة تقول في يوم. يلا بسم الله إن شاء الله. Today let's learn something. I'm not saying everything. I say something about الصلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Just learn something. First of all, الله سبحانه منشأ القرآن من سورة الأحزاب. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي. يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. So what is the meaning of الصلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ What is the meaning of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes salah on Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Is that means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prayed to someone? A'udhu billah. Why? I mean, which is this point? Because we have some people, especially from other religion, they have in their book that their God prayed to someone, okay? So it's not in Islam. The word itself have many meanings. As-salah. So, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ. First of all, يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. If salah comes from you, we are servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are human, right? If we are making salah, على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم means we are making dua. We are making dua to say Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praise him and raise his darajat in Jannah. This from our side, as ibad, as servant. As-salah from al-malaika, from al-malaika angels. That also they are making dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala praise Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Not praying to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Be careful from the word. Angels not praying to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All of us praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. But they are making dua to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes salah on Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, doesn't mean a'udhu billah that he praying for him. Like praying, like worshipping a'udhu billah. Not like that kind of meanings. Because some people unfortunately misunderstand. It means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prays his prophet in al-mala'il a'la with the angels and blessing him. That's the meaning of as-salah ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Second point, as-salah ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is sunnah or wajib or fard or what? As-salah ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in your life is fard at least one time. Fard. الصلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم is fard in your life at least one time in your life. Then after this one time, ulama have like opinions if it like wajib or mustahab. But all of them agree that at least one time in your life is fard. You must do it at least one time in your life. You must make صلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Then after one time, then they have opinions. Is it wajib or mustahab? For example, in our mazhab al-Shafi'iyya, it's wajib. Malikiyya, wajib. Some other mazhab say it's mustahab, but you must also, as I mentioned before, must make it one time as fard. Third point. In a tashahhud, when you are making your prayer and then you are in last tashahhud, before you make salam, what is the hukm of as-salah ala Nabi sallam at that time? In Ahnaf al-Sunnah. Malikiyya al-Sunnah. In Shafi'iyya, fard. If I forget to make salah ala Nabi sallam in my tashahhud, my salah is invalid. You can imagine? Invalid, not acceptable anymore. I have to repeat again. So based on the mazhab and the evidence, how they understand the evidence. But you can imagine how important is as-salah ala Nabi sallam. In our mazhab, if you forget to make salah ala Nabi sallam, or just you know but you didn't pray, like you didn't make salah ala Nabi sallam, according to Shafi'iyya, your salah is invalid. Finish. You have to repeat again from the beginning. In other mazhab, at least, is sunnah. Sayyidina Umar Khattab radiallahu anhu said, as-salah, prayer, and dua. It will not be acceptable without as-salah ala Nabi sallam. You can imagine? Your salah, you pray your salah right, you pray your fard, it's okay, no problem. Your fard is finished. But to be accepted or not is another issue. So you make your fard is finished, alhamdulillah. But to be accepted or not, Sayyidina Umar Khattab radiallahu anhu said, if you didn't make salah ala Rasulullah in your prayer or in your dua, it will not be accepted. Other meaning of the same point. This is how to make salam alayhi salam. So we mention the first point. What is the meaning of salam alayhi salam? Now, is it sunnah or fard? In total, in your life, again, repeat to not misunderstand. In your life, in total, one time is fard. You must repeat. You have no excuse. At least one time. Then later, after you make this fard, it will be wajib based on Shafi'iyah and Malikiyah. As of course, also it's wajib. At least it's sunnah. At least it's sunnah. Then, point number three, when should I make Salah alayhi sallam? Is there like certain time I should make Salah alayhi sallam? Look, in general, you can make Salah alayhi sallam at any time. At any time. But if you see, like, if you speak about best timing, you know, like you can, as jaiz, you can make it at any time. But if you speak about best timing, then let me tell you little, not everything, just little. Now, today, you came to the mosque, right? All of you came to the mosque, right? When you enter the mosque, it's mustahab to make salam alayhi sallam. To say bismillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah, Allahumma ghafir li dhunubi, wa aftah li abwaab rahmatik. This dua to enter the mosque. You start this dua with as-salaa ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You say again, bismillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah, Allahumma ghafir li dhunubi, wa aftah li abwaab rahmatik. When you go out the mosque, say, you say bismillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah, Allahumma ghafir li dhunubi. Instead of say, wa aftah li abwaab rahmatik, just this word rahmatik, change it to fadlik. Waftah li abwaab fadlik. So the dua is same, it's very easy. If you remember the first dua, you can see the other dua when you go out to the mosque. Just only one word changing. Instead of rahmatik, say fadlik. So you enter the mosque, you say bismillah, memorize it. Just learn even one thing today. Just one thing. Bismillah, wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah. Allahumma ghafir li dhunubi. Ya Allah, please forgive my sins. وَافْتَحْ لِي أَبْوَابَ رَحْمَتِكَ. When you enter. When you go out, say the same dua, just change one word. Instead of the last word, رحمتك, put فضلك. So you say, بسم الله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله اللهم اغفر لي ذنوبي وافتح لي أبواب فضلك. This one thing, it's صلاة والسلام مستحبة in the dua. Second thing, the hadith mentioned in Sahih Bukhari, or Imam Bukhari, عن سيدنا جابر بن عبد الله رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من قال حين يسمع النداء اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة آت محمدا الوسيلة والفضيلة وبعثه مقاما محمودا الذي وعدته حلت له شفاعتي يوم القيامة. والله very beautiful hadith. And if you understand this hadith, you will never stop making salah alayhi sallam. You know why? I want to know why. The best thing in the hereafter, in the day of judgment, is shafa'at of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Shafa'at of our dear Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because even some people who made sins, kabair, like high sins, big sin, even they can receive the shafa'at of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They have chance. But you need to increase the chance. How to increase the chance? You need to make efforts. Not to sleep like this and make just sins and say, Shafa'a of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will come to me. It's not like this. So one of the reasons which can make you receive the Shafa'a of Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is to make Salah alayhi wa sallam after Azan. When the Muazzin finish the Azan, of course you repeat after him. If you say Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, you say also Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And except Hayya ala Salah, you say La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Hayya ala Salah, also you say La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Then when the Muazzin finishes Azan, you say, Allahumma Rabbah hadhihi da'wah al-tamma. The hadith mentioned Sahih Bukhari, narrated by Sayyidina Jabir ibn Abdullah, radiallahu anhu. Allahumma Rabbah hadhihi da'wah al-tamma. Was salat al-qa'ima. Ayat Sayyidina Muhammad al-wasilata wal-fadila. Wab'athu maqaman mahmuda al-lazi wa'adta. What is the reward? Hallat lahu shafa'at yawm al-qiyama. He will receive the shafa'at of Sayyidina Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the hereafter. And if Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes shafa'ah to you, it means you are going to paradise. If Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes shafa'ah to you, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it means you are going to paradise. Don't lose that chance. It's very easy to make salah alayhi wa sallam. One of the nice things to make salah with Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam during Azan and the Iqama. During Azan and the Iqama, in this timing, your dua is mustajab. Between Azan and the Iqama, after Azan and before the Iqama, your dua is mustajab. But as I mentioned in the beginning of the khutbah, your dua can't be acceptable without the salah on Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Then when you start your dua, you say Alhamdulillah, or just praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make salah on Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Easy way. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا رسول الله. Then you make your dua. Then when you finish your dua, so صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Start your dua with praising Allah سبحانه وتعالى and الصلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. You giving high chance that your dua will be acceptable. Many things to make صلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The best day to make صلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم is today, يوم الجمعة. This day to make salah on Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, according to Ahadith, is Yawm al-Jum'ah, day of Friday, today. Make salah on Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam from the night until Salatul Maghrib. Best day to make salah on Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. أما بعد، روى الإمام الترمذي عن سيدنا أبي كعب رضي الله عنه قال يا رسول الله إني أكثر الصلاة عليك فكم أجعلك في صلاتي؟ قال ما شئت. قال الربع. قال ما شئت وإن زدت فهو خير. قال الثلث. قال ما شئت وإن زدت فهو خير. قال النصف. قال ما شئت وإن زدت فهو خير. قال الثلثين. قال ما شئت وإن زدت فهو خير. قال فأجعل لك صلاتي كلها. قال إن فعلت كفيت غفر لك. أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. This hadith والله is one of the best hadith I have read about الصلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. سيدنا أبي بن كعب رضي الله عنه speak to سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. The hadith is mentioned in Al-Tirmidhi, Imam Al-Tirmidhi. He said, Ya Rasulullah, I make salah on you, I make salah on Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam many times. So, in my day, in my zikr, what do you recommend for me? I make like one fourth, like ruba, quarter. He said, it's okay, but if you increase, it will be better. He said, okay. One third, thuluth. He said, it's okay if you want, but if you increase, it will be much better. He said, half. He said, it's okay, but if you increase, it will be much better. He said, two-thirds, three-thirds. He said, it's okay, but if you increase, it will be much better. He said, I make all my zikr, only salah alayk, ya Rasulullah. He said, if you did it, kufit wa ghufr alayk. Means, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will like make your life much better, and he will make you avoid many bad things, and he will forgive all your sins. Bifadl salah ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This hadith just not memorized. Listen and understand the meaning. Kufita wa ghufra lak. If you, we have another hadith actually mentioned that the person who makes salah ala Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the angels are making dua for him until he finishes his salah. So if you make one time, angels will make 10 times for you. We have another hadith on Sayyidina Anas ibn Malik رضي الله عنه. He said, من صلى علي صلاة واحدة صلى الله عليه بها عشرة. If you make salah عليه الصلاة one time, Allah سبحانه وتعالى will mention you in the ملأ الأعلى and forgive your sins, and the angels will make dua to you that Allah will forgive your sins and like give you a chance to go to Jannah 10 times by one salah. If you make 100 salah, how much will be? 1,000. If you make 1,000, how much will be? 10,000. Just by your tongue. 5 minutes, you can make 100 times salah Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. You can make more than this. So the best thing that you make, Salah Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Allah will give you a chance to have the shafa'a of Sayyidina Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the hereafter. This one is the best thing in your life. And the person who makes Salah Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam now Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not alive, right? But the person who makes salah alayhi wa sallam, the angels take your salah and deliver it to Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he hear it and he respond to your salah. Not only that, they mention your name. You see, the son of this person is the son of that person. He made salah, Ya Rasulullah. Then Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam respond, how honor you have now? How much honor you have now? To make salah alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by himself respond to your salah. Actually, if I speak about salah alayhi wa sallam, we have like many things to speak about, but just give you like hint, a few points to realize how important a salah alayhi wa sallam. And last point, the person who doesn't make salah alayhi wa sallam, you have hadith on Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu, who said, Rasulullah sallam said, al-bakhil, kullu al-bukli, man zukirtu indahu, falam yusalli alayhi. The person who is shitty, kitschy, in Hebrew, kitschy. When he hears the name of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he doesn't say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He's a very kitschy person, very bad person. Even his chance to have the shafa'ah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is very low. Why? He doesn't even love him. If you love someone, you mention him always, right? If you love someone, you mention him always. But when we speak about Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when I say Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you must say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. At least show some respect for him. And last point, you think that if you make salah alayhi wa sallam, you are giving him benefit. No. The benefit is for you, not for him. He doesn't need anything from you, okay? Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam doesn't need anything from you or from anyone. We need him, not he needs us. When you make salah alayhi wa sallam, you are doing it for your own benefit, not for him. Put it in your mind. When you are making salah alayhi wa sallam, you are making a chance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive your sins, because we have another hadith, one salah. The angels will make dua for you 10 times, and 10 sayyat, 10 like sins, will be cut from your kitab. And 10 hasanat will be written. And 10 darajat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise your darajat 10 times in thereafter, by one salah alayhi wa sallam. What about if you make 1,000 salah every day? How it will be? If you want your life to be fixed, make salah alayhi wa sallam. If you want your heart to be cured, make salah alayhi wa sallam. If you want your iman to increase, make salah alayhi wa sallam. If you want Sayyidina Muhammad sallam to give you shafa'ah in the hereafter, make salah alayhi wa sallam. This at least you can do, inshallah. عباد الله إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات اللهم تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم واغفر لنا وارحمنا إنك أنت الغفور الرحيم عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم وأقم الصلاة
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله أكبر.
This international conference brought out the Brothers Benito and they are completing the mission. Inshallah, someone will to do it for them. They are going to be outside if you can meet them, inshallah. And they are going to do